Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I got this question about structuring a weekly report. I talk about creating a weekly report in my book, Soft Skills, a Software Developer's Life Manual. And in that book, I've got a couple of chapters where I talk about career stuff and about how to really do well in a corporate job or in a regular job. And one of the things I talk about, one of the techniques that I've often used, that I pretty much use for every job once I figured this out, was this idea of creating a weekly report. So basically, I got this question about how to structure the weekly report. I'm going to answer that in a minute here, but I want to talk a little bit about this idea of a weekly report. So this is something that I sort of stumbled upon. If you've ever been a manager, you know that one of the most important things, one of the most difficult things for your job is getting people to tell you what they're doing, or rather to know what they're doing, to get the communication, right? To check on your people and say, hey, is this task getting done? To know what the progress is. You're basically, gathering information from all these people. Like a good manager does this, is they gather all the information and they send it on up, they summarize it, and they check the progress, they make sure that things are going right? They're keeping all the pots on the stove cooking, right? So that's what a good manager does. So what the reason why I'm saying that is because as an employee, what you can do to help your manager, to make them look good, is that you can give them that information. So here's a quick tip for you that's going to help you a lot. And it's something that you should do, I think, for every job, whether you're asked to do this or not. And something, when I took a new job, I would do, this is the first thing I would do. On the very first week, I'd send out what I would call a weekly report. And so it's real simple. All I did was this, is every day I would track what I did, right? What did I do? Make a few bullets of what I did. What did I accomplish? Were there any big accomplishments? And any kind of kudos that I got, any kind of thing like that, and just track that. So I'm basically tracking my accomplishments and my tasks and what I'm doing each and every day. And then at the end of the week, I would send a weekly report that's a summary of all of the days that I did, and then a little bit of more information, like maybe like a highlight of the week, or what I'm planning on doing next week, any kind of, maybe if I have a question, or I have something that's blocking me, right? And I would send that out to my manager unsolicited. The other thing that I would do is, on the first week when I send this out, I would explain this process, and I'd say, look, this is what I'm doing. I just want to, to let you know, to make sure that you know what I'm doing, what I'm working on each day. So I'm going to send you this report every week if that's okay. I've also CC'd your manager on this just in case you're sick or you're out or something, so that information will go to someone so they know what's going on, just in case that you're unable to get to this and to report that information, if you're out. So if you don't mind, I've just CC'd him just as an FYI, just so that he has this information, right? And no one ever complained about this, right? They loved it, right? It was a very popular thing to do. It's such a valuable thing. And there's a couple reasons why this is valuable. So one of the main reasons why this is valuable is because, like I said, you're helping your manager by giving them all the information they need. You're one less person they have to manage. You're basically like a free roll for them. Like they're gonna love it because they don't have to go and check on you and figure out what's going on. Communication is so important. As being someone who manages a team now, I can tell you that if I have an employee, someone who's working for me, who communicates well, I love it. It's so awesome because I don't have to guess what's going on. I don't have to bug them, and they're giving me the status. It's so awesome. So you're gonna be valuable there. Not only that, but a lot of times a manager will be managing a very big team, right? And so if you can be the person who's always in front of them, every week they're seeing what you're doing, they're seeing what your accomplishments are, you're gonna stand out. And that's really, really important. And because it's really easy to do a whole lot of good work, and if no one knows what you're doing and how hard you're working and all these accomplishments that you're having, it's not gonna matter, right? Especially when review time comes around. So that's another big point, is when review time comes around, this is sort of a CYA, right? I'll tell you a quick story. One time I was working for a corporation, I won't name the name here, but they were doing stack sorting, which, if you don't know about that, stack ranking, basically they have certain number of people that they're gonna give an S grade to and certain number, an E or whatever it is, right? And they basically, have to, they don't grade you on performance, they sort you, only certain number of people can get the promotion or get the raise or or be graded well, and some people have to be near the bottom or just meets expectations. Well, I got near the bottom one time on a review, and I was kicking butt. I mean, I was definitely one of the most productive employees, but the problem was I had just been promoted. So, you know, in order to political correctness type of thing, they people with more seniority that hadn't been promoted for a while, they needed to move them up, so they moved them up to stack rank. And I was not very happy about this because I don't like that. It should be a reflection of my ability. I should be judged on, you know, and if I'm competing against people, if I kick their ass, I want to be at the top, right? I don't want to be at the bottom. Well, lucky for me, I was able to send the review board and my manager a list of 50 accomplishments that I accomplished that year. Of big ones too, right? And I knew exactly what I did every single day of the year. The evidence was so overwhelming that they ended up moving me to the very top because it would have been an HR nightmare to try to justify having someone above me or moving me that low when there was this documentation that I made sure went into my HR file that showed all these accomplishments. I had it documented. I had inconclusive proof that I deserved the raise, and I got the raise. And so that's super valuable, especially when you have to fill out your review and you say, what did you do this year? What did you accomplish? And you can list so many things. It's awesome. It's really awesome. So it's well worth the investment of like a few minutes every day to keep track of this. Not only that, but it's a good CYA as well. I also had an incident where someone who didn't like me was trying to get me fired. And they said, well, John's not doing much work. He's, you know, I saw him doing this, or he was taking a long lunch. And guess what? When it went to HR, I said, what day was I not at my desk or not working or didn't accomplish something? Oh, okay, February 3rd? Yeah, okay, here's exactly what I did on February 3rd. Oh yeah, and I sent it to my manager and I CC'd his manager, so I didn't just make this up. So I've got the email here. guess what happened? Guess what the result of that was? It was very clear who was trying to make things up and who was being honest, because I had the conclusive proof. So anyway, it's extremely valuable for those reasons. It's something that's really easy to do. So here's what you do. And I'll get to the question here. So here's the format. All you do is this. It's real simple. Every day, you just take a few bullets of the major things that you did. And the format that I would put it in is, don't send this every single day. Send it once a week. Put Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. This is what I did. Like three to five bullets at the most. You want it to be quick for someone to read so they actually do read it. And just summarize what, you know, and highlight the accomplishments. Make them look good, right? And then put a little bit of a summary. Maybe a little bit, you don't want to write a novel, you want to make this real easy to do, and that's the format. It's simple as that. You know, you could use your own format if you want, but here's the thing, I'll give you this tip. Do not make it too complicated, because if you make it too complicated and you make it too much work for yourself, you're not going to do it every day. And if you don't do it every day, the value gets dropped off. You got to be consistent with this, right? This is the key here. So just make it simple. Make it something that you could do in 5 to 10 minutes. What I would do is throughout the day as I'm working on something, I would just open up my file and throw my bullet point in there, and I'd have that file ready for the end of the week. And then at the end of the day, 10 minutes before I left, I would go and I would straighten it up and make sure that I had it there for that day so that I wouldn't have to sit there on Friday and try to remember what did I did on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, right? I've been there, done that. You don't want to do that. So anyway, this is something that's extremely valuable. Like I said, check out my book. If you haven't gotten my book, seriously get it. Soft Skills, Software Developer's Life Manual. You can get it here. I also have an Audible version where I record the audio. I threw in some extra content as well. So, you know, definitely check it out. And if you do have the book, I would really appreciate if you leave a review on the book. I really appreciate that. You know, that it helps other people find the book. So anyway, that's my tip. Hopefully that answers the question here. I've got a few questions about the reports, but I think it's a really good technique. I highly recommend doing it. It is something that can really make a huge difference in your career. And it's just, you know, it's going to make your manager's job easier. And if you make your manager look good, it's going to be good for you. I promise you. So anyway, if you have an question, you can email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like this video, subscribe to the channel. All right, I'll talk to you next time. Take care.